start first with Alice Goh, because both the Senate and the House of Representatives are fighting for her custody. But criminal cases have already been filed. So how do we go about this, Yusek? Who gets custody, and should this really be an issue?
It's not an issue. It's something that can clearly be coordinated between all the relevant bodies that wish for Alice Goh to appear with us. Mm-hmm. So what's going to happen is that the moment that the custody of Alice Goh is turned over to PASIG, I believe, we will regularly coordinate with Congress to ensure that Alice Goh attends any hearings that take place there.
Okay. So when her custody is transferred to the PASIG City Jail, who will be overseeing her detention?
It's the BJMP that will be overseeing her detention.
Mm, all right. Arguments of Alice Goh being a state witness, why should this be considered, Under Secretary? Because the basic premise of a person being the least culpable is already moot for her. Why is the DOJ still pushing for this?
Well, we're not pushing for that. No one in the DOJ is pushing for that. Mm-hmm. Statements for Alice Goh is not on the table. It's not even in the kitchen. It's nowhere in the horizon. So if ever there's anyone who's putting that out there, I can categorically say that's fake news.
Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you for clarifying that. Alice Goh's lawyer, they have prepared fraudulent documents. We have seen how they are responding on different hearings by the Senate. What are the DOJ plans for that? Has there been any movement on your end, Under Secretary?
That's clearly a problem for us. That's clearly a very serious concern for us, the submission of fake documents in our proceedings. So we have tasked our group within the DOJ, which consists of prosecutors and law enforcers, to look into the possible administrative and or criminal liability of the lawyers of Alice Goh.
Mm-hmm. Has there been talks of possibly filing a disbarment case against her lawyers, Undersecretary?
It's one of the things that's being considered, but we have to realize that disbarment is quite a very serious result. So disciplinary proceedings against lawyers can result in many things. It can result in something as serious as a disbarment. It can also result in something as minor as an admonishment. So right now we're just open to anything. We're looking into what's possible out there, and we're going to take action in due time.
Mm-hmm. All right. There has been talks about an unnamed Philippine police chief that allegedly has helped Alice Goh in leaving the country. The PNP is investigating 24 former chiefs. What's the DOJ's stand on this, Yusek?
Well, we welcome PNP's action because that information, we heard it from General Villanueva of PAGCOR. So we truly welcome any action in the PNP to look into the culpability of any of its former chiefs.
Mm-hmm. Has there been any update from the PNP to your department regarding on the 24? Maybe there has been some leads into who might be those who have been able to help Alice escape?
On that specific issue, none yet. But we are in coordination with PNP on a variety of issues. Mm-hmm. So hopefully, if they do come up with something significant, we will hear from them.
Mm-hmm. The whole nation has been looking into the POGO investigation and the hearings on both the Senate and the House of Representatives. I was wondering, for the Justice Department, in terms of your own investigation, where are you here, Undersecretary?
Oh, we are very active in the investigations against POGOs. The case against the Banban Pogo that was recently filed, that was filed with the active involvement of our prosecutors in accordance with the recently issued Department Circular 20, which Secretary Remulla issued early into his term, which ensured that there be active collaboration between prosecutors and law enforcement. This case that's pending before PASIG against Alice Goh and a variety of individuals, that is the product of DC-20, as well as the other human trafficking case on the Porak Pogo, where Cassandra Leong is one of the lead respondents. That is yet another product of DC-20.
Mm-hmm. There's been a lot of issues regarding Pogo, and one of the things that we're looking at are the foreign employees of Pogo that might need to be repatriated. Can you give us an update on this, Yusek?
Right now, we are coordinating with some of the other agencies on how to handle the winding down of the IGLs, whose licenses will eventually be canceled by the end of the year. So those agencies include DOJ, BI, PAGCOR, PAOC, and DOLE. That's one of the areas that we are looking at. And one of the things that's been agreed upon now is that the foreign employees of the licensed IGLs, they are given until October 15 to voluntarily depart. Afterwards, their 9G visas or their working visas will be downgraded to tourist visas, under which they will have around 60 days, 59 days to stay in the country. And if they still remain in the country, we will undertake deportation proceedings against them.
Because it's easy to go after those who were employed by legal pogos, but what of those who are employed illegally?
For those who are employed by illegal POGOs, our approach will be more aggressive. Clearly, for them, there's no 9G visas. There are no legal visas to talk about. So for them, the moment that they are apprehended in any of these illegal POGOs, deportation proceedings will commence, unless they are being held to answer for criminal cases.
The issue of the alleged mass grave, has there any been update on that, Undersecretary?
None yet. I believe that this week our prosecutors, in coordination with PAOC and law enforcement, continue to build up the application for a search warrant. Hopefully by next week there will be significant progress there, if not a filing of the application for search warrant.
Since the sona of the president, how many POGO has been shut down or is already in process of, and are there more that we're looking into?
When it comes to the legal POGOs, the IGLs, I believe at the time of the SONA, there were 42 licensed IGLs. By now, according to PAGCOR, there are just 40. Two have already voluntarily decided to cease operations. And of course, by the end of the year, in accordance with the president's directive, all 40 should be winded down already. As for the illegal POGOs, we have undertaken some raids in coordination with PAOC, the most significant of which was the one in Lapu-Lapu City, Cebu. And there are several more in the pipeline.
There are reports of Chinese nationals running illegal pogos in different parts of the country, even in Cebu, the one you said. Has there been of those that we have seen, the illegal pogos that we have been able to shut down, are majorities of those who have made it operational really foreign nationals?
It appears that the ones who are running the show, who are the top officers of the bogus, are foreign nationals, and usually they are Chinese nationals.
All right. With that, I'll let you go. Thank you so much for your time. Undersecretary, you have a good afternoon ahead of you.
Good afternoon.
Thank you.